Hi, my name is Chris. I'm a software engineer and language learning enthusiast at our Duolingo office in Berlin, Germany. Today, I'm here to celebrate diversity in language and would love to take you on a whirlwind tour through some of the world's writing systems. Along the way, I will tell you about some of the new features we've been developing to help you learn them. As you know, Duolingo has always been a great way to learn languages such as Spanish, French, or German. If you're an English speaker, many aspects of these languages will be familiar to you. For example, even if you don't speak these languages at all, you'll still be able to recognize the letters in words and type them in your phone to look them up in a dictionary. However, Duolingo now teaches many languages such as Japanese, Korean, or Arabic, to just name a few, that will feel much more different. Here, you can see common greetings in some of these languages. One thing they all have in common is that they use writing systems that are different from the letters used in English, Spanish, French, or German. This is only one of the aspects that makes learning these languages different, but it's an important one. So, last year, we formed a new team dedicated to improving the learning experience in these kinds of courses. Today, I'm super happy to tell you about one of the improvements the team has been working on. To really understand what we've been up to, though, let's take a closer look at some of these writing systems, starting with one of our most popular learning languages, Japanese. A Japanese sentence can be very different from an English sentence. If I wanted to write, "I am German," in Japanese, this is what I might write. Did you notice that there aren't any spaces? And even more interestingly, this sentence actually uses characters from three different writing systems in Japanese, all mixed together. There's hiragana, which is the main writing system in Japanese. Each of its over 40 characters represents a syllable. Then there's katakana, which is mostly used for foreign loan words or emphasis. Each of its over 40 characters represents a syllable. And then there are kanji, which are adopted Chinese characters. There are thousands of kanji, each with one or more pronunciations and meanings. So, in order to read authentic Japanese text, you first have to learn these three writing systems and become comfortable reading text without any spaces. But don't worry, we've been working on a new feature to make this both digestible and fun. And here's how it works. There's a new tab in our Japanese course that will teach you two of the three writing systems, and rest assured, we're working on the third. If you navigate to this tab, you will see reference charts containing all the characters along with their English readings. You can tap individual characters to hear how they sound, and there's also a big Learn the Characters button. If you tap it, you will be guided through a sequence of lessons created by our language experts. Like the regular Duolingo lessons we all know and love, these lessons are bite-sized, meaning that they only focus on a handful of characters at a time. You also get helpful tips on pronunciation and things to watch out for along the way. Additionally, we've built several new types of exercises, such as this tracing exercise, that will help you become more familiar with the shapes of the characters. As you go through the lessons, the characters you've learned will light up in the chart to indicate your progress. Once you're done with the chart, you will feel comfortable sounding out words in the writing system. This feature has been live on Android for a little while now. It is now also available on iPhone and iPad. We're also working on a web version. We started with Japanese because it's one of the hardest languages to learn how to read. It's also one of our most popular courses. But once we had this feature developed for Japanese, we wanted learners in other courses to benefit from it as well. Russian, Ukrainian, and Greek all use alphabets that are similar to the one used in English. But just like with English, it can be difficult to learn what pronunciations go with particular spellings. So, for these courses, we developed a new set of lessons specifically geared towards making this easier for our learners. Next, let's talk about Korean. As with English, a Korean word consists of one or more syllables. But Korean is unique in how it visually represents syllables. Individual letters come together to form syllable blocks. And what's interesting is that there are different syllable block patterns. For example, look at these two syllables. They both consist of a consonant plus a vowel. But notice how one is arranged horizontally and the other vertically. And there are even more patterns than just these two. In order to effectively teach individual letters coming together to form syllable blocks, we devised a new exercise type that works just like a puzzle. You have to fit individual letters into the puzzle to form a syllable block. We think our learners in Korean will really enjoy this. And this is what it looks like in Korean. As with Japanese, you get reference charts, curated lessons, tips, and new exercise types. Next, let's talk about Hindi. Hindi is somewhat similar to Japanese in that individual characters usually represent a syllable. One thing that's characteristic for Hindi is that individual characters are joined by a horizontal line and neighboring characters visually connect or even merge. It looks stunning, but you need to learn to tell the characters apart. Fortunately, we're also bringing our new feature to this beautiful writing system. Next up, Arabic. In Arabic, which is read right to left, individual letters visually connect to form words. One thing that's interesting about Arabic is that the shape of a letter depends on its position in a word. The same letter might look different depending on whether it's shown by itself, at the beginning, the end, or in the middle of a word. This helps give Arabic its beautiful flowing aesthetic. You can see how in this example, the same Arabic letter changes its shape based on its position. What's also tricky is that vowels aren't traditionally written in Arabic, but might be indicated by little marks, like the A in this example. So you can tell that this magnificent writing system is fairly tricky to learn. But don't worry, our new feature is also coming to our Arabic course. I hope you will enjoy it as much as I am. Next, Hebrew. As with Arabic, Hebrew text is read right to left and uses small marks to indicate vowels. When native Hebrew speakers write in the language, these vowel markings are not usually written. When Hebrew speakers read a word without vowel markings, they use context to determine what word is intended. And if they know the word, they know how it's pronounced. If they read an unfamiliar word, they can look it up in a dictionary to find its pronunciation written with vowel markings. To address this for our Hebrew course, we're adding a set of lessons that teaches you how to read the language both with these vowel markings and then without them. I also have good news for learners in one of our newest courses, Yiddish. Like Arabic and Hebrew, Yiddish is also read right to left. The Yiddish writing system is related to Hebrew's, but unlike Hebrew, the markings for vowels are typically written, except in words of Hebrew origin. This can be confusing to newcomers to the language. Fortunately, our Yiddish course will have you covered. So, to recap, we talked about many of the world's languages and writing systems, each unique and beautiful in its own way. Now, you can learn them in a fun and effective way on Duolingo. Just look for the tab in one of these courses. Please stay tuned for further improvements in these and other courses. Thank you very much for your attention and enjoy the rest of your Duocon 2021.